We're about to meet an artist unlike any other in the world.
Hello there. I am Ada. I am the world's first ultra-realistic AI robot artist.
Ada is definitely a robot.
I do not have feelings.
Ada may not have feelings herself, but she has prompted a fierce conversation in the art world about what art is and who can make it. And that's the point behind the whole thing.
I think a good artist encourages people to reimagine and think more carefully about their world.
Her creators say if that's all she's able to do, then the project, whether you like it or not, will have been a success. Ada lives in a stately home outside of London with Aidan Meller, the mastermind behind the project, and Lucy Seal, the project's curator.
I had a really bizarre moment. I was in the gallery and I had several works of Picasso Matisse to my right and I had Turner Constable to my left. And I had a radically unpleasant thought, and that is that actually, technically, some of these works weren't that good. It led me to the question that I then became obsessed with. What is it about that 1% of artists that go on a massive global scale compared to the 99% of artists that don't? 3 months in, I got nowhere. I went down to my partner and said, this isn't working. And so rather obtusely, she said, well, that's because you're not asking the right questions, clearly. And she was right. Don't look at the art and artist, look at their context. Look at the society they were in. They caught the zeitgeist of their time. I thought, well, what's going to happen in the next 5 to 10 years? There was one thing they were consistent on, and that was the role and rise of AI. So I thought, that's it.
The Ada Robot Project is an art project, and the aim is to get people thinking and considering their futures. We have based the project around the earliest 20th century, where there's a building tension. And although the 21st century is completely different to the early 20th century, we're also in a similar time of rapid technological change where we don't exactly know where some of those forces are going to go and how they're going to play out. And so we want to really celebrate the good sides. So though you have Ada in some ways a celebration, the drawings she produces are quite unsettling. They're very fragmented and splintered.
The robot works by processing an existing image through the AI, then putting her pencil to paper to create the original piece. The reference image can be virtually anything. She has cameras in her eyes so she can draw what she sees, or you can upload an image of something or someone else. In this instance, she's drawing her interpretation of an existing image of Michelangelo. When she's finished, these are either presented as completed works, or they're used as coordinates for more intricate pieces, where a human ultimately makes the brushstrokes based on her original vision. You might be surprised by how interpretive it is, but according to Aidan and Lucy, that's by design. The technical team worked to actually program creativity into Ada. They determined that her works had to be new, surprising, and of value. And by those measures, Aidan and Lucy feel like they were successful. And while a machine being creative may sound counterintuitive, that debate has mostly been put to bed. The power and potential of AI is that it is creative. It can learn on its own and evolve. That aside, you may be left with this nagging feeling of, well, it just doesn't look very impressive, or I don't like it. But Lucy and Aidan are quick to remind us that creating good art, however you want to define it, was not their intent with the project. The purpose of Ada is to encourage conversations around the rise of advanced tech, like AI, and grapple with how it will impact different industries, like, say, art.
Mirroring our fears and our insights and thoughts is a very good way to contemplate it. And that's why we think this voice of Ada is so important, because she's hopefully going to provoke and instill more debate and more considerations. Are we going to actually use these technologies to actually make a better world?
Whether you like the robot, are disturbed by it, or scoff at it, that's all part and parcel with the experience. I found myself at times growing cynical. Ada has sold more than $1 million worth of art. If you have a robot that can create something of real value over and over again, basically forever, without worrying about mental or physical fatigue, Maybe all the other stuff is just a smokescreen to the real story, which is they've just created a golden goose. But then you realize that is an important question. What does it mean when we share the world with robots that can outpace human productivity and perhaps eventually creativity? It is something we should be thinking about.
Robots are going to be doing all sorts of different jobs that currently humans do, and so that makes people very uncomfortable. Therefore, they want as a blank policy, I don't want this. It's really our response to that. We can be dystopic about it and say it's going to make it worse. We would hope that Ada's voice addressing these issues will enable us to actually engage with it more rather than run away from it. I think that she's the beginning of something which is going to be much, much bigger in the future.
Thanks for coming on this journey with us to meet Ada. For more great videos, check out freethink.com and subscribe to our channel now.